It is Vlogmas day five. Christmas is coming so soon. I was looking at the calendar. We have the rest of this week. We have one full week to pack in Christmas activities because the next week is Kaylee's birthday, Kaylee's little birthday trip to Dallas, and then it's Christmas. I cannot believe it. I penciled in on my calendar, finish Christmas shopping. I need to go by one store today and get something for Mason or see if they have something for Mason. He is so hard to buy for this year. His favorite toys include sticks, dirt, rocks, cardboard boxes, the little air packs that come in all of my shipments. What else does he play with? He gets out all of my bags of coffee out of the pantry and like lines them up on the couch and then plays with them the rest of the day. He also grabs a handful of plastic spoons out of the pantry and plays with those all throughout the day. So those are his favorite toys and I have no idea what to get him. I mean, I don't want to spend a lot of money because he's not going to play with it. Kaylee, on the other hand, is hard to not buy for. I have a limited number of presents I'm going to get them. A few from Santa and a few from us, and that is it. So it's really hard to contain myself because there's so much she likes right now. But first, I'm gonna go in here and get ready for the day. I hardly ever have time before I go drop off the kids. I hear about this magical pickup line or drop off line where you can wear your pajama pants and your slippers. Unfortunately, for a Mother's Day out like my kids go to, we have to walk them inside, talk to all the teachers, like, they get me in all of my glory every morning when I drop them off. So I'm looking forward to a drop-off line where I don't actually get out of the car. We have another meeting for the house today. We have to go to the lighting place and pick out all of the, well, actually a bunch of different stuff. So, all right, so I'm gonna go in here and get ready. It is an errands kind of day. So I'll see you back here in just a little.
I gotta share my outfit of the day because it took a very different turn than what I started out with. I put on my shirt this morning that I was going to wear and found a big hole in the sleeve. I think I've worn that shirt maybe twice, so I'm really disappointed with that. And it's not even like on a seam, it's just a random hole in the middle. It's very odd. So I was like, what other like lightweight long sleeve shirt do I have? And I just got this one in the mail that I showed you that says Darlin'. And so I put it on with some jeans and I was like, hey, let me do some snakeskin western boots. And it just turned a little bit western, so I really like it. It's what I love about fashion. You can reinvent yourself. I would say that I never dress western, and this isn't like over the top, but it's just fun to play. It's just fun to see what it morphs into. So that is what I am wearing today.
Making a liar out of myself. I couldn't help myself. It was so good yesterday, but I went to a different Starbucks and this one isn't nearly as good. I think they put way too much syrup in the one I got yesterday. This one is a lot less sweet and flavorful. I mean, it's still good, but yesterday's was amazing and this one is just not quite as good. It just needs like one more pump of syrup to be perfect.
How do you feel about shopping for the house?
Exciting times.
I went western today. What do you think?
I like them snake shoes.
Do you see what my shirt says?
I like it.
They also have one that says y'all. You need to go back and get it. You don't have to just...
Oh no, I'm filming this.
But you're me.
That's me. Say hi to Santa. All right.
Hello, how are you?
Good, how are you doing? Oh, look how cute this is. Oh, that is so cute. I love mud pie. Look how cute that cookie set is. I like these, but they're eeekk, so they're expensive. Well, that was not nearly as bad as I thought it was gonna be. It didn't take nearly as long. None of it was like decorative lighting. It was all like outdoor lighting, garage lighting, up lights for the front of the house. So it didn't require a lot of brain exertion. So it didn't take very long, which is good because I got a lot to do. I'm trying to figure out what takes priority because I really need to go get my nails done, but I'm not sure that's top of the list. These dip nails chipped almost immediately. I had never been to that salon before and I'll never be going back. They chip so bad and I'll probably end up putting it off because I hate going to the nail salon to get my nails done. It is not relaxing to me. It is not a form of self-care. It's just, I hate it. I feel like I'm wasting my time. It takes forever. It's like uncomfortable to me. I don't know. I don't like people messing with my nails, my nail beds. Just not my thing. And so normally I do my own nails, but had a lot of things I wanted my nails done for this month, you know, with being the holidays and doing Vlogmas, and we had pictures done, the pictures we had done on Sunday, but now these are looking bad. I think I'm gonna go dark next time. I want like a really dark, dark berry color, and then I'll probably get them done one more time before Christmas and do a Christmassy red. All right, I think I'm gonna go buy the new house because there's a few things that I need to look at. Plus, Greg said that there are kitchen countertops in. They grouted some of my tile and some of my floor tile, so I'm excited to see that for the very first time. So I'm gonna take you and show you. Let's go see what they've done. Oh, it looks good. All of this is covered in plastic, so it's kind of hard to see the true. I love the big veining. I went back and forth on whether to get like small, subtle veining or some really big veining in our quartz, but Greg wanted the big one, and I really do like it too. Oh yeah, it's pretty. Yay! I think that's the only countertops in though. Oh, that's exciting. I can't wait. Oh, it looks good. They got the grouting done on the subway tile and my penny tile. I love it. I did white grout on the subway and then I did white penny tiles. Houston, we have a problem. These are shiny penny tiles, and these are matte. They're supposed to all be matte. They're matte like 3/4 of the way up, and then this row right here is all glossy. You've got to be kidding me. But as far as the color goes, I love it. It's really dark grout to make these really pop against this.
All right, if he says it's not an issue, but it's gonna be another day, 2 days, 3 days work for them to tear that out, reinstall it, and then regrout the next day. So we'll see. And this tile is covered in,
this tile is grouted. I haven't seen it grouted, but it's all covered in plastic. Let me see if I can. Oh yeah, that looks good. I wanted the grout to be as close to this gray as possible and just kind of blend in. So I think it's really nice from far away, especially. It makes the black really pop. Love it. The walls in here are black. Well, they're a soft bluish black. But they look really good with the tile. Can't wait to get fixtures in here and, you know, add something to the black walls. It's really gonna make it pop. All of the master bath floor tile is covered. Just a little bit. Maybe I can pull one of these corners back. There we go. Oh yeah, I went with the darker gray. And I'm glad I did because, well, it actually looks darker on camera than it is in person. It's not as dark as I thought it would be. I just wanted to stay clean looking, and the lighter grout would not have been clean looking in just a couple of years. Ours looks terrible in our house now after 9 years. Yeah, it definitely looks darker on camera than it does in person because it's just a medium gray. Yeah, it's not picking it up good, but I like it. I can't wait to see it all uncovered. All right, upstairs bath. Those stairs made me out of breath. It's time to get back in the gym for sure. Somebody left their Fiesta mix. Looks good. This is the exact same grout that we have in our bath. And it looks just as good with this tile. Look how pretty that tile is. It has huge sweeping veins. So pretty. Oh, it looks good. That's our polished chrome. It's called Schluter. That looks so good. It just makes those pop. You can't even hardly see it on the edge. I think the white bounces off of it and kind of makes it blend in, which is good. I don't mind that at all. Oh, it looks so good. So they grouted this tile in a really dark color. I wanted it to just kind of blend in, be monochromatic. And then went back and forth on what to do here. I was either gonna do white or really light gray. I think this is the same as the floor. And I love it. I think it really brings out the textures of the tile more than white would have. So glad I ended up with the chrome because it looks so sleek.
So I am at our local ranch supply store. It's super busy in here. Some of y'all are probably like, you're taking this outfit a little too far, but they have a ton of cute toys for boys. Let me show you what I got, Mason. Cute. Kaylee has one of these. I forgot what hers is about, but this is the farm one. Mason's gonna love that. And then a little stacking train. And then I got some stuff for their stockings. Pop rocks. Do y'all remember this when you were a kid? I'm gonna put this in Kaylee's stocking. I love the Tootsie Roll fruit chews. I've never seen just a bag of these. Atwoods is where I'm at. Ranch and Home Store. Oh, and I also got some sweet tarts for their stocking. All right, he got a little four-wheeler. So that completes his Christmas. I think I'm done with Mason. Almost done with Kaylee.
We are hiding all of the Christmas presents in our
RV, our camper. I'm about to take them all in there because it's time to go get the kids.
Eating his favorite food on the planet. He loves a baby food pouch. Luckily, they make the toddler ones that are a lot of veggies or a full serving of veggies. Is it good, bud? How was your day at school?
This is my favorite.
Goldfish? That's not your favorite.
I like them.
How was your day at school?
My day was awesome.
Did you learn a new letter?
No.
You didn't learn a new letter today?
Nope.
Did you learn anything today?
We did paint.
You did paint?
Uh-huh.
Kaylee, are you ready for the Christmas parade tonight?
That means yes.
We're having apples and peanut butter for a snack. It's the first time I've ever bought whipped peanut butter. Oh my goodness. This is a game changer. This is so good. What do you have on? Mason. Uh-oh. Let me help you. Okay. Show me what you've got.
This one right here, we got.
Can I
there we go.
I think it's Mason's turn. No, oh, hold on, Mason. Not that one.
No, we can open two.
No.
What is it?
So punch kids.
Bat it off, Mason. Now Mason gets one more.
Is there four?
There's four. Awesome. No more.
Tell them what you said, Greg. We really love our kids.
Yes, we love our children because we are going to a parade tonight. And
we really don't want to go.
No.
Where are we going, Kaylee?
We're going to the parade.
You can't see her. It's pitch dark. We're going to a Christmas parade. They're gonna have fun. It's just, we're just tired and the parade lasts a really long time, but I'm sure that we'll leave early because it'll be Mason's bedtime here in just a little bit. Greg got home and he cooked dinner for me. He was so sweet. He cooked tacos while I took a power nap and I woke myself up once snoring. I was so tired, but I had to get in a power nap to make it to this parade for sure. What do you think? Cheese. It's a video. Are you excited for the parade? Are you excited? Are you excited? Come here closer and tell them.
So today we're having a Christmas parade and I see a car coming and I think they were about to start. And so I think it's a good time to just talk for a little bit.
Oh, you don't want to talk? Okay.
Thank you. so bold to see a revolution.
Ready, set, go.
Ha 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 ha